Delilah, Oba Eto Samson, then I say, well again, who again? Read the Bible. For demons have forsaken what? Me. Read again in the Bible. What again?
Moses.
Moses. Moses. Moses is here, demons are. Now, I'm going to have Moses, Sam, and Moses is quiet. So, nobody, God is saying that He knows everybody. He created us in His image. Nobody is 100% as strong that stands on the foundation. No. But God has laid a principle for you to defeat the what? The devil. The principle to defeat the devil, first of all, for anyone who is living in this world, God is saying that I have brought my son Jesus Christ into the world. If you believe in Christ, if you repent of your sins, if you are baptized, you come into the family of what? Christ. When you come into the family of Christ, you have to stay and make the necessary preparation by putting the oil in the lamp. The oil that you put in the lamp is some of your daily prayers. And some may be away to me here then. You have to pray every day. Christ prayed every day. Even the Son of Man prayed every what? Day. How much more you? How much more you? Sometimes Christ go without food. Sometimes you have to go without food also. When you mean business, you have to go. He fasted. How much more you? Christ said, you have to come to church. Church coming is so important. It's the foundation. See, about her, not about somebody. You see, when Adam and Eve met, Adam and Eve were together, the devil ran what?
Away.
When they separated, the devil attacked each of what? Of them. So when the Christians gather together, the Bible says that when two or three are gathered in my name, I am with what? With them. But when you go individually, that's where the devil attack you. So when you stay at home, the devil attack you. And if you don't know, you might lose this great word, salvation. Because Hebrews chapter 2, verse 2 to 3 is telling us that how can we escape if we neglect such a great word, salvation, which was first been spoken of by the prophet, and then it was translated to the apostles, and now it's to us. How will you escape the judgment seat of God? So Christ is telling you this morning that be thou ready, for you don't know the time or the hour that I'm coming. Neither the angels in heaven knows the time or the hour, but God only has his time, and the time is that you have to prepare and remain very faithful in the eyes of what? God. Making the preparation, putting the oil in the lamp is abstaining from sin. Sin is an abomination in the sight of what? God. Sin can lead us into everlasting what? Hell. Sin can separate us from what? God. Sin can block our prayers from reaching the Lord God Almighty. But how do you abstain from sin? To abstain from sin, we have to be reading our Bible. We have to do good works. We have to extend our heart to those in needy what? People. We have to remain faithful. Because the Bible is saying that in Revelation chapter 3, in Revelation 2, verse 10, the Bible says that the devil will put some of you into prison for 10 what? Days. But thou remain faithful even unto death, and you will receive the crown of what? Glory. And that is what the Lord is saying. Sometimes temptation will come on your way, but God is saying, stand on your what? On your feet. When the world is tossing you upside down, the Bible says, stand on your what? On your feet. When your friends have neglected you, the Bible says, stand on your what? On your feet. When you are being tossed right to the left, the Bible says, stand on your what? On your feet. So as I'm ending my short sermon this morning, my message for you this morning is that be prepared, for you don't know when the Lord is what? Is coming. Do not get prepared and prepare for tomorrow. Prepare today, because procrastination is evil. It won't lead you to your heavenly what? Glory. It will let you what? Down. But when you stay prepared and know that you are in Christ, then the Bible is saying that what is in you is much greater than what is in the what? in the word. And then you can say with the psalmist that the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I what, fear? That the Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be what, afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came up upon me to eat up my flesh, but they stumbled and what, and fell. Though a host should encamp against me, my heart shall not what, fear. Because the Lord is what, is with me. Though war should rise against me, in this I will be what, confident. For one thing have I desired of the Lord, is that I'll dwell in the house of what? Of the Lord. Dwell in the church of the Lord. Dwell in the church of the Lord. All the days of my life, all the days of your life, to behold the beauty of the Lord, to listen to the teaching of Christ, to listen, dwell in the house of the Lord, to listen to the teaching of Christ. And then you, in times of trouble, he will hide you in his what? In his pavilion. In the secret place of his tabernacle shall he hide you, for he shall deliver you from the hands of the what? Of the evil one. So my brothers and my sisters, stand very firm. Be prepared. Don't give up the fight, because it's a fight that we are all what? Fighting. The way to heaven, Christ has opened it. But you have to walk one step at a time, one day at a time, and then you will reign the heavenly kingdom. May the Lord bless all of you. May the Lord give you encouragement and strength.
Amen.
May the Lord strengthen all of you.
Amen.
May the Lord let you realize that you are in the church of the Lord, the pillar and the ground of what? Of truth. And that if you remain faithful, the heavenly way is for you. Amen.
Amen. Amen.